Hi, I'm Jim Vosicek.
And I'm Bernie Lindstedt.
Today we're going to give you an overview of the brand new 9R tractors from John Deere. I'm going to cover the new JD14 engine, ballast, and some cab lighting options.
And I'm going to take you to this 9RX and look at the undercarriage. We're going to go to the back of the tractor, talk about our hydraulics, as well as up in the cab, talking about flow sharing, and touch on FieldCruise, and highlight some of the comfort and convenience and lighting packages.
We're going to cover the brand new JD14 engine from John Deere. So this is a totally redesigned engine from the ground up. It replaces our 13.5 liter engine we've had for the last several series of tractor. So to start off with, I'm just going to pop off this cover here and show you. So we've got a really handy filter overview guide. It shows where all the filters are and where the service intervals are on the tractor. So everything's right there. So you pop this cover off, there's a whole bunch of information right there for you, similar to what we see on some of our other series tractors. When we go to pop the hood, one of the main customer feedback things we've had with our hood for the last several series is it's really tough to lift, heavy to lift. So you'll see we've got two handles that are placed on the front of this hood. So we're just gonna pop the latch, same as we used to. And actually they've added a spring. It's 37% less effort to open the hood. So compared to what you're used to, it's going to be a lot easier to open. Now, when you take a look under the hood here, what you'll see is it's a total different look. They've put the gear train on the back of the engine to reduce noise and make some room. It's a belt-driven water pump, high-pressure common rail fuel system, so we've gotten rid of the injectors, and it's also a hydraulically driven fan motor. So what all this means to you is it's a much more compact-looking engine compartment, a lot less noise up in the cab, and a lot of the same efficiencies we've seen on our 9-liter, which has been an extremely popular engine for us. So if you think of the new JD14 as kind of an overgrown 9-liter engine from John Deere, you're going to see a lot of commonality in it. We're better on fuel consumption, we're higher on torque, and higher on power. So in model year 2022, this is going to power our 490 through 590 horse tractors. Model year 22 still will run the 15 liter Cummins, but for 23, all of our platforms are going to go to this common JD14 engine. So we're very, very excited about the changes and can't wait to see what you think about them. So with the new JD14 engine, what you can see here is we've got a single canister treatment system. So we've opened up the whole right hand side of the cab again. So if you look back on either any of our Cummins models for 22 or any of our legacy models from prior years, we had the canister coming out here for treatment. That's gone with the new JD14. That's all integrated in to the engine. So this is all back open again. So a very nice change of visibility on the right-hand side of the cab. All right, let's talk about ballast a little bit on the new 9R tractor. So we've got increased limits on the new 9R. So the 9R540 here, the 9R540 through the 490 have a total ballast limit of 60,000 pounds. That's an increase from where we were in the past. Our 9R640 and 9R590, we can actually go all the way up to 67,000 pounds. So the thing I'd like to note here, a lot of this ballast has actually been built right into the tractor. So we've got many heavier components. It's a heavier frame. The transmission's been beefed up. You'll see some of the castings on the rear end have also been beefed up. So some of this ballast is actually achieved through a redesign of the frame itself, not just hanging weights on it. So that's a big change for us as we go forward. On a tire, optimal slip is 8 to 12%. So if you're above that or below that, you may want to consider your ballast level and maybe adjusting that for different field applications. The other thing is the front and rear axle load, that's where we're going to get the recommended PSIs for our tires on our tire tractors. So if you want us to, with these base weights being different on these new tractors, at the dealership we've got a great ballast calculator. If you're getting one of these units in the field, please come in and see us. We'd love to run you through the different options. We can spec the thing exactly how your tractor is built and give you what the front and rear axle weights are. That way you can get your tire PSIs dialed in properly. The recommended pounds per horsepower for ballast is 110 pounds per horse. So keep that in mind. We can run it through the calculator and let you know exactly where you're at.
Now let's take a chance to talk a little bit about the new look to the 9RX640 undercarriage on this front assembly. We'll notice here, as we're built from the ground up to meet the horsepower requirements, we have a bigger drive system with 20 bolts on this idler. smooth face design. This one is equipped with the scraper kit for the mud and the debris. But in years past, we had to check our track tension from in the cab. But now we have the convenience of working on our track system with the green indicator down below. If we're in the green, we're good to go. As we come around to the back of the tractor, let's talk about the 9RX or the 9R hydraulic system. With a single pump in base configuration, or as this tractor has, the option of dual hydraulics at 110 gallons per minute. So when we deal with dual hydraulic systems, we're talking about two pumps, with pump number one dealing with your bottom three SCVs, pump number two dealing with your top three SCVs in this configuration. So when it comes to priority, let's remember that our power beyonds will take the priority over our SCVs in order. But we also have to remember when hooking up our implements that pump one supplying oil to one, two, and three also deals with our steering and our brakes and a three-point hitch if equipped. And pump number two would take from that in certain situations. Therefore, we remember that priority goes to power beyond, then to the lowest SCV off of each pump, and then alternating up the stack. Now we're gonna jump up here into the cab of this 9R tractor and talk about our hydraulic flow sharing on and off button. So let's look at hydraulic flow sharing as we go to our hydraulics, advanced settings, and making sure that our hydraulic flow sharing is either on or off, with on being highlighted in the brown. When the flow sharing is turned on, it provides hydraulic flow priority to those SCVs that are set in continuous flow mode. This would be like vacuum fans, planters, or air seeders, where we need that continuous flow rate as required per operation. When hydraulic flow sharing is shut off, now we're providing improved hydraulic performance in applications with multiple down pressure functions or implements where constant flow rates are not as critical. It allows the hydraulic system to operate at its maximum hydraulic capacity regardless of our SCV settings. Let's spend a little time talking about FieldCruise in our Gen 4 command center in this 9R tractor. Let's remember that we can adjust our FieldCruises by simply raising and lowering our set points for desired settings in one and two. We operate the tractor with the throttle wide open and highlight that by hitting the button on the side or being in contact with your display. We need to remember when we're operating FieldCruise that the tractor only has the available power bulge in according to the actual engine speed setting. So if we're operating at 1900 RPMs and we drop down to 11, we have to remember that we are also declining the capacity for our power bulge. So if we're in a heavy tillage application or a ripper or maybe a high speed heavy load that requires maximum engine speed and power, FieldCruise should be disabled and we should reset to our maximum pulling capacity. This particular 9R tractor is fully equipped with the Signature Series cab, which gives you the ultimate comfort and convenience package, as well as the ultimate lighting package. In this cab, you'll notice the leather seat, which is fully automotive style now with electronic controls, lumbar, heated and ventilated, and the 40-degree right-hand swivel capabilities. We now have the touchscreen radio, XM ready, with a 6-speaker system and a subwoofer built into the roof, with greater head clearance as the heating and cooling system has been removed and relocated behind the seat. We have more power options in our corner, and the steering wheel system on this 9R tractor is that of a more of a automotive style feel, with the telescopic capabilities and the functionality.
So all of our 9Rs are equipped with the Ultimate Visibility Package. The Ultimate Visibility Package is also included as part of the John Deere Signature Edition. So as you can see, we have 360-degree lighting around the top. So this is equipped with 24 cab lights. They have 2 times the light output of our previous models. The other thing you can see is there's some additional lights that are around the air intake as well that we didn't have prior. And while we're there, you look up, you can see the brand new redesigned mirrors. Those mirrors are power adjust and power telescoping. So that's all part of the Ultimate Visibility Package. Well, as you can see, these new tractors are a lot more than just a new sticker and a new cab.
That's right, Jim. We ask that you take the time and come and visit with us at Leading Edge Equipment to find out more details about this family of 9R tractors, as Jim took us through and started with the big change with that JD14 engine.
And from there, you can see the extra weight, everything's beefed up, everything's designed for these high horsepower applications. It's not the tractor for today, it's the tractor for tomorrow. So these tractors are ready, Leading Edge Equipment's ready, let's go hit the field.
And as always, we thank you for your business and we wish you the very best in 2022.